Mr. Kaul, do you think there is excessive and mindless violence and vulgarity in Indian films today?
I think there is violence and vulgarity, but to call it excess, you have to compare it with the total stock of film production in the country. I think when you take the total stock of film production, then you find that violence and vulgarity is coming basically in two segments of cinema, that is the Hindi cinema and the Tamil cinema. So to that extent, I would say yes, there is an exaggerated violence and vulgarity in these two language cinemas.
Now, what do you think makes producers take recourse to such measures as excessive sex and violence?
Well, I think in this case, it is pure commercial pressures. That pressure is coming from either the distributor or the producer, who thinks that these are ingredients which are very popular in public tastes. Whether they are or not is a moot point.
What do you think? Where are they?
Well, I think anything which is banal, which is vulgar, which touches the baser instincts of one's tastes is easily attractive, because you don't require an education, you don't require an upbringing in a certain environment where you can say no, this is bad. So because the country is, let me say, cinematically very poor in its education, this kind of an opportunity exists in the countryside, that you can cater to such banal tastes and get away with.
But Mr. Kaul, going by that logic, just cut it for a moment. I'll just
rolling.
Now, like having such scenes and such maybe songs and scenes,
yes,
and pelvic thrusts and gyrations and what have you.
Yes.
Do you think that these things actually drive the masses into cinema halls? Do you think that really happens? That translates into money?
Well, the business of cinema is now mainly generated from the metropolitan towns. And here are people, there is a very large segment of audience which goes to cinema halls who are practically uprooted. They don't have parental influences working on them. They have spare time also. And in this spare time, they are trying to feed their baser instincts. Earlier, we had, when parental influences worked, you had films with religious themes being sure shots as business propositions. But now, as the audience strata is younger in age and without an elder's influence, these films are becoming more sure shots, financial, from the financial point of view, than the earlier ones.
And do you think that such depictions, as we were discussing,
yes,
they influence the overall morality of the audience?
Oh yes, they do. It's a dangerous trend. And personally, I'm very worried about it, because there is no application of brakes from the general society in this. Recently, the state has intervened, expressed its annoyance. But one major disappointment that I have is that, you see, Indian cinema is now entering its 100th year of existence, and yet we have had no such development within the industry where you can call that a social censorship exists, where there is a realization of responsibility by the makers on the influences which this media can have on the general society and audiences. And in the absence of this, I have felt that the state intervention has become an imperative need for society.
Now, the state does, state is intervening in terms of the censor board, which is largely a government sponsored body, if not,
yes,
completely government in its composition. But do you think that the censors basically have lost their teeth? They are not being able to implement the guidelines, or what is?
Well, the guidelines have always existed, and they are pretty stiff. They had remained stiff starting from the first cinematograph rules for censorships way back in the early 1950s. there was a change in the framework of the censors board, and that was, first it was a censor board, now it has become a film certification board. So the attitudes have changed. Secondly, it's got decentralized. Earlier, there was a lot of film review work and using of the big stick from Bombay, from the central board. But now, after its decentralization, regional tastes have influenced the decision of members who are sitting in the board, because they are all non-official members, including ladies. And over the years, they have been influencing the their own decisions, their collective decisions on individual cinema productions.
Now, there's this thing about how do you differentiate between artistic and aesthetic depiction and crass commercialization? Now, there has been this talk about, like, I recently heard one commercial filmmaker say that if Maya Memsa, if you know, Ketan Mehta shows
yes.
something on Maya Memsa, that's aesthetic, and if I show something on.
The first thing I would say is, does this film which claims or should be claiming an artistic excellence have any storyline or not? Because if a film like Maya Memsahib and its genre can be exempted from the normal critical eye of the censors, then they have something meaningful to suggest. I am not against violence per se in cinema, because violence has its own very fundamental place in human activity. But we must see, we must examine case by case the objective of the so-called creative artist. I can see a very violent film. There have been a couple of instances lately where very violent films have been the subject of a critical view of the censors. The censors have given one view, but then if that becomes a yardstick for others to follow, then I would object, because others will only follow it from the commercial point of view. Here, such films which I am claiming that violence is justified in these films, I would say, since the director was very, very firm in his views about what he wanted to portray, that portrayal included violence. And it was a violence which had to be explained again in film. It was not violence for entertainment's sake, but violence because it became necessary. There, I think, you have to accept violence.
Okay, now, who's to judge? Like, who's to judge, I mean, what is an aesthetically done film and what is crassly commercial?
Well, the composition of the Board of Film Certification has people who are educated, they have a culture in them. There are those who see the critical point of view, they see also the entertainment point of view. And I think their view, which is the resultant of the discussions that go along with such meetings, their view should be honored. And I wouldn't mind if there are some people added who have a claim to being very cultured, if their presence can add to this kind of discussion, and artistic films are also supported properly, then they should be welcomed.
Now, with the foreign television now such a force in the country,
yes,
you have
a large number of them.
Large number of them sort of beaming directly into your drawing room. Now, there you can. How can you sort of prevent a completely different set of values sort of coming into your drawing room? Maybe, you know, nudity in that culture is not as dark as maybe as one would sort of get to see in,
yes, yes.
in the films.
I get it.
But then you have it nevertheless, and your children are getting exposed to it. Things
I am of the view that why should we be so apologetic about our own culture? If this is a culture which is coming on foreign television network and it represents a kind of culture located in another part of the globe, I feel we, now that we have a very big network of our own, both in public and the private sector, I think we should become more aggressive about our own culture and not ape the kind of software that is coming on to our television sets. And we have much to offer by way of good entertainment also.
But the other argument, that one about body lyrics and all these, which seem to catch on.
Well, we have body lyrics of our own.
Yes,
and
that is what
it's
I'm
part
coming.
Of the part of our folk tradition.
Can you
now,
go back?
Yes, yeah, we can.
Can you please repeat the thing once again? Because what I was the question that I'm asking you is that, body lyrics are being used, one, on the ruse that it is part of our folk tradition.
Yes.
On the second, this thing pretext that, how do you counter the onslaught of MTV, which is affecting the film industry per se?
MTV is I would say, it's a little difficult to define, because one could defend the same issue on artistic values also. At the same time, damn it, because it is an exaggeration of body movements. Some of its lyrics certainly require censoring. And I wouldn't mind MTV or its kind of music and visuals, but it requires moderation. And I think the worldwide view is the same. Even the kind of morality boards that are existing in the Western world, particularly church-dominated boards, they don't damn MTV totally, but they say it requires moderation. I'm also for moderation, but I'm not against MTV. And I would again feel that we should not be worried so much of MTV, provided we can counter it something of our own. Because MTV is only gaining grounds in India because we have not offered something alternate to MTV. And we have popular entertainment, music entertainment, even gyrations, I would say, which can do very well abroad.
Yeah, but I mean, as a measure to counter a form of vulgarity,
yes.
Do you think the only alternative is to...
No, I will not say counter
vulgarity
by vulgarity. No, it should not be that. I am saying that we have the ability in our own culture to present something which titillates and yet is not vulgar. There have been some film songs also which you could say could be termed as titillating, but then they have not been vulgar. But on the other side, they have been very vulgar presentation. It is not the lyric that is offensive as much as its visual accompaniment. And we have had titillating music over these decades. It's not that it is a recent discovery. Even some of our very ancient poetic works, they are very erotic, and we have not damned them. There have been film songs which have been very erotic. We have never objected to it. A song like in film Pyasa, there couldn't be anything left to imagination. Yet it is iced in or sugared in total bhakti movement. And it is still considered one of the best bhakti movement songs. Nobody objects to that. You see, it is how you present an idea visually. And I think here, we are totally concerned with commercial considerations when we are presenting grotesque, exaggerated body movements. If they were to be controlled, the problem is under control.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.